gap filler is a response to the earthquakes. It's a creative urban regeneration initiative. So the idea is that we activate vacant sites around the city with temporary creative projects for community benefit. So it's very much about responding to the situation here and now in the city. Word of mouth is a really powerful way for something like this to get out there. Also because, you know, we don't have the funding to advertise, and actually it's not really our style anyway. Social media is something that I've had to make my peace with through Gap Filler. It's not something I am that inclined to use myself. It allows us to communicate quickly, use images, use video, allows us to call for volunteers or ideas. People submit ideas to us using it. It's really a fantastic tool for us, and it fits with the kind of ethos that we have of being responsive and adaptive and pretty immediate. So for us in Gap Filler, we're really interested in moving away from just being seen as a feel-good, happy earthquake thing, and more towards being about regenerating the city and involving everyday people in their community and volunteerism. And so that's a sort of shifting of the message, which is coming now sort of 2 years on as we grow up as an organisation. So that's an interesting sort of communications challenge. My crazy ride post-quake has been one of redundancy and then creation and inspiration and lots of volunteerism, and then real tragedy in the earthquakes and losing my house and keeping Gap Filler alive and developing it into something that's really quite amazing, and gathering a small team of us to do it. So I never would have thought that I would this would happen to me, of course. My world has expanded. I'm now far more involved in community work and volunteerism than I was beforehand. And I've learned an amazing amount of new skills, because Gap Filler routinely bite off more than we can chew.